All right, guys, I'm going to be doing a quick mic check. Did I just it's different for you guys for it is for me and my how I have it set up. Give me 2 minutes, guys, and we're gonna go ahead and get started. All right. How's everybody doing tonight? Thanks for stopping by. You're watching Cousin Drew's Cooking Show, Episode 5, The Mile High Burger, starring my dad, Larry Canepa.
Starring me? No.
Thanks, everyone, for stopping by tonight. Really appreciate it. All the support's been amazing. You guys are the greatest. Thank you so much. We got the whole setup out here in Colorado. We've been tweaking things all day long. So if there's anything that you guys hear that we need to adjust as far as sound-wise, go ahead and let me know. I need to adjust one thing real quick. Let me test it. Yeah. All right. There we go. So this is my dad, Larry, guys. This is who I learned a lot of my cooking growing up from, was him and my mom. My dad's an amazing cook. Cooks at home all the time. So we're here to show you guys bison elk burger tonight. We're going to be doing a 50-50 ground bison, ground elk. I'm going to get a little bit closer for you guys to see. We're going to be doing 50-50. We're going Colorado themed. We're up here in the mountains. Elk, super common. Bison, super common. People come out here all the time to hunt. My dad can give you guys a little bit more knowledge about that while I get these open.
Yeah, there's not too many people who don't eat game meats here. We get other meats as well. Like, a lot of people bring in, they'll go hunting even other places, but bringing meat in here, and a lot of the restaurants will serve things like moose, antelope. I mean, you can get all kinds of different things here, but these are definitely the two most popular of the game meats, or elk and bison. Bison's really cool because it tastes so much like beef, but it has hardly any fat. I mean, it's a very, very lean meat and super healthy, just high protein. I think that's probably the most popular of the game meats, but we do burgers all the time with bison. I mean, what I do is I kind of do a run to a local butcher and kind of stock the freezer once a year with a lot of frozen. I do ground, but I'll also do bison steaks, which are fantastic. And they got the deepest red. You talk about red meat, they're almost purple, like lamb. They're so beautiful. So,
oh, yeah.
Tasty. And but a lot of people, you could give them a bison burger, wouldn't even know that it was beef. So it's kind of interesting, you know.
Ma, love the apron.
That's right. Seuss, represent, right?
So like my dad said, super, super red meat, guys. We'll go ahead and show you me meat. Super, super red, right? Super, super red. We can give you the little down low, all right? So super, super red meat. So I got both in here. We're doing a perfect 50-50 blend of elk and bison. Both super gamey meats, right? A lot of people, they're not really into the whole gamey meat thing. So this way that I'm going to prepare these burgers tonight for you guys is going to go ahead and add a little bit of freshness, add a little bit of flavor, and it's really going to take away the super gaminess that a lot of people don't like about the meat. My dad's cooked it a lot. I've really grown up eating it. I really do enjoy it. I like it a lot. I don't mind the gaminess. I don't even really see it. But the way we're going to add, you know, some fresh parsley, some fresh garlic, some fresh seasonings in there, it's really going to, you know, exactly. It negates the gaminess, and it really adds like a whole new flavor. And it's delicious. Like, you know, this kind of meat is, you know, what we grew up eating, you know, back 60, 50 years ago, even backdating 100 years ago. It's like, you know, wild game. That's what people were doing. They're hunting and gathering. And this is, you know, the original thing. So we're going to go ahead and get started on this. Let me see who's up in the chat tonight. I already see a couple people in there. I see my little Quee. I see Mom. I see Liz. I see Sammy. Sam said, what's up, Larry?
What's up, dude?
We got Nate Dog. We got G-Mo. We got Max. We got all the
OGs.
We
missed G-Mo, right?
Yeah, G-Mo's not here. It's the first episode that we don't got G-Mo here. So a little bit of rundown what we're going to be doing, guys. You can go ahead and do exclamation recipe, and, you know, it's going to go ahead and pop up for you guys. So what we're going to be doing is I'm going to be working on the meat. I'm going to be adding in the seasonings, doing a little bit of chopping of everything, you know, let you guys see how we get down. While I take care of this, my dad's going to be taking care of the sweet potato chips that we're going to be doing. We're going to be doing homemade sweet potato chips on the side. Super, super delicious. Basically, you know, we got our sweet potato here. We did a couple practice cuts on the mandolin, you know, to get it right. So we're going to be using a mandolin. We're going to be slicing, you know, whole sweet potatoes. We're going to soak them in some water. It's going to help kind of pull out all the gross, you know, like, you know, things that are sitting in the skin and stuff like that. And it helps take away the bitterness of the raw potato. So we're going to have them in the water. We're going to let them sit. He's going to go ahead and dry them off. And then we're going to go ahead. We got tonight on my dad's stove, we're going to be doing the burgers in the cast iron skillet. And then we got a deep fryer set up on there. So we're going to go ahead, And we're going to get the sweet potatoes in the deep fryer. We're going to make some homemade potato chips with these. Toss them with a little bit of cumin, coriander, and salt. Super tasty. They'll be a nice compliment. Kind of like a, you know, like a happy hour type of burger and chips. So I'm going to get started on the meat. My dad's going to go ahead and take care of those, get those sliced up. We're going to be doing the burgers on brioche buns tonight. If you guys don't eat brioche, it's super, super delicious. Unbelievable. Nice bite to it. Super fluffy, so it doesn't take away when you toast them up. They don't get super hard. They stay nice and fluffy, just perfect with the bite on the burger. So the burger's going to be topped with some fresh butter lettuce. I got some delicious heirloom tomato. I'll be doing whole grilled red onion, which we're also going to be cooking on the stovetop first to kind of season the grill up already. So we can actually get those started, Dad. If you want to go ahead and turn the cast iron on, and we'll get those onions marked off. We'll get those ready. We'll refire at the end. Get them heated up.
Go about medium?
Yeah, go about medium. We'll be fine. So we're going to be topping it with, like I said, the fresh heirloom tomato, which adds a great sweetness, the sweet butter lettuce. Whole grilled red onion adds a nice little bite. We got some fresh avocado. We're going to be doing a nice half Dijonnaise. It's going to be a half whole grain mustard, half mayonnaise spread on the bun. We'll be grilling that into the bun and then give one more wipe after just to, you know, get the flavor going. We got some ground Dijonnaise right here. It comes in whole grain as well, but this is already ground, so it's nice and, you know, liquidy. And then just some, you know, regular old mayonnaise. So we'll do like a nice 50-50 of that. Spread them on. Shawnee, I see you in there. What's going on? King David, how you doing, man? Thanks for stopping by, brother. We're going to be using whole coriander. We're going to go ahead and crush that, sprinkle it over the chips. And then I'm also going to top off the burger, you know, for looks, plating. It looks really beautiful. But then you also can eat it with the burger as well. We got some delicious... sweet cherry peppers, right? Some sweet canned cherry peppers, along with some mini kosher dill pickle. Now those are gonna be stabbed into the top of the burgers at the end. Add a nice little beautiful presentation on there. Maddie, I see you. Thanks for stopping by, big dog. How's it going? Hope your night's going well. Here's our brioche for tonight. Fresh baked at the store. Nice fluffy brioche bun. So we'll get those going shortly. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to start on this. I'm going to have my dad start marking off the onion. I'll slice the onion up real quick so I can show you how I want them.
Okay.
And then we'll get those going. Okay. Let me just go ahead and wash my hands real quick. Dad, if you want to grab those onions and
you got them on the board.
Yep. We're going to put the garlic over here while we're at it. Just set it to the side.
Perfect.
Nice red onions. Andrew kind of personally picked everything yesterday to make sure all the ingredients are fresh and at their peak. So. You get the first use of my good Cuisinart knife, too. Oh, yeah. I'm liking that.
Brand new knives my pop's got, so I'm going to go ahead and break them in. I don't want to bring my knives to the airport, look like some serial killer traveling to Colorado or something. Maddie, thanks for stopping by again. You guys crack me up always. All right, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and get these onions sliced up real quick. So when I do whole grilled onion, these are nice and sharp.
Yeah.
So when you do whole grilled onion, obviously, we're going to keep them nice and round, but you need to get this layer of skin off. So I just kind of made an incision along the onion, right, just to get that top layer. And I'm going to peel that top layer of skin off. My eyes are about to start watering. I already feel it. So we're going to go ahead and get this top layer of skin off of this. Break down the other side. There we go. All right, so peel that off. Get that rind off there. We don't need that. Get the skin off. The onion, perfect. Get all this out of the way. You can use, you know, goggles or glasses if you're that big of a wussy. Or you can just deal with the watering pain of the onion. Don't hurt nobody.
Isn't that like a rite of passage?
Max already coming through with the 100 bits. What did we just get? 500 bits from Maxie. Thank you very much, Max. Those of you guys that are stopping by for the first time, bits are Twitch currency, like I've said before in the past. It's just a way of tipping. Thank you very much, Max. I do appreciate that. You guys came through like crazy with the bits last week, and I couldn't thank you guys enough. It's honestly awesome. Thank you, guys. I appreciate that. All right. So with the onion, I'm going to go ahead, and now with the onion, the whole grilled, when you cook onion, they get you know, soften up and everything like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make like a nice, you know, decently thick incision, because these things are going to cook on both sides and I still want a bite to them. I don't want you to like bite and it be mushy. You want the bite of the onion in there. You want it to have released all its oils. You want it to develop color, but you still want that bite of the onion. So when I slice, I'm just going to make some nice incisions. I'll show you guys the thickness that I decide to go. That's the top, so we'll not worry about that. So the you know, how we're looking here, about a quarter inch, guys, on the onion, right? Just straight down, nice and even. Some of the onions might tend to break up. The thicker you cut them, the easier they tend to stay. You want to try to stay as equal as you can down the onion. Keep them pretty even. If you go one side a little bit smaller than the other, what tends to happen is one side will cook faster than the other. So you want to kind of avoid that. You want equal cooking amongst the entire onion. So I got some nice onions come out. We're cooking for 7 tonight. We got my 3 sisters are here. We got my sister's boyfriend, Nathan, who's up in the chat. His name's Nate Dog. We got me and my father and my stepmom, Jenny. So I'm going to be feeding 7 of us tonight. So we're doing enough food for 7. So I got to make sure I got enough for everybody, even if they don't use it. Okay. So we got our onions. What are we at? 6?
6, yeah.
I'm going to go into this onion.
For Aubrey, the little one?
The little baby onion for the little one. Let's go right there.
There you go.
Perfect little cut. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to have my dad throw some oil up on the cast iron. Okay? Get some fat going on there. Put these rest of the onions over to the side. Preserve those for later. Yeah, you're good. All right, so he's going to go ahead and season up the cast iron for you guys. My dad's got a really, really, really beautiful cast iron skillet. Uses it all the time. It's nice and seasoned up. Keeps it nice and greased up with oil. It's in really good condition. How are the eyes feeling? Eyes are burning up a little bit, I'm not going to lie. Alyssa Canepa coming through with the another 500 bits. Thank you very much, Liz. I appreciate that. You guys are already starting off. Brit style leftovers to Clinton Debbie. What's going on, Uncle Clint? How you doing? Thanks for stopping by the stream. If there's any leftovers, you may get it, or I might eat them tonight. Let's see what happens. What I miss, what's going on, Alec? We're just getting the whole grilled onion down. Kaylee, thanks for coming in. Yeah, a little teary red. All right, guys, so we're going to go ahead and get these onions down. You can hear the sound, a nice little crackle and pop. That means that they're nice and hot. I'm going to have my dad go ahead, throw the rest of the onions on. I'd probably fit like 4 on there at a time. I'm going to go ahead and get my cutting board ready, cleaned off a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and season this meat up for you guys. So while he's in the back doing that, I'm going to get the ingredients. We're going to throw some fresh Italian parsley and some fresh garlic, which I'm going to have to chop up for you guys into the meat, which is really going to help complement the gamey flavor. It's going to overtake it with freshness. All right, one set. All right, guys. So you got some fresh bunch of Italian parsley. We'll go ahead and get a cutting view guys for you guys. All right. So just going to take our bunch of Italian parsley. We want to chop it up nice and small. I just kind of get it bunched up right before I'm going to cut it. Just kind of make sure it's all there. Light, fighting tears. Yeah, it's a pretty fresh onion. So it does make my eyes tear up a little bit tonight. So I'm just going to give it a nice rough chop and then remove that. Give you guys a little peek over at the onions. All right. Dad, you can go ahead and sprinkle a little bit of salt and pepper on those onions.
You got it.
All right. We'll go back to the board for you guys. We're just going to go ahead and give the parsley a nice chop. I want to mince it up nice and fine. Breaking in the new knives for Pops. Andrew should travel the country and do shows in different people's houses. Yeah, just walk up to random strangers' houses and ask if I could use their kitchens. Have all the gear ready to go. So you can see the Pops is putting salt and pepper on the onion, guys. Season them up. Make sure you lock in the seasoning. Salt's going to also bring out the moisture of the onion, like I've said in the past streams, but for you guys that weren't there, salt is a preservative, helps draw moisture out of things. So you put that on the onion, it's going to help pull the moisture out and help develop color on them quicker. And then obviously flavoring them with pepper. And by cooking the onion first, it's also seasoning up the cast iron skillet for when we're going to put the meat on, which is going to be delicious. So I'm back over here on the board. I got the parsley minced up pretty fine, right? We're looking good on that. And go ahead and kind of shove that to the side. I've got my handy dandy bench paper with me. So I'm going to go ahead and use a knife, which works just as well if you guys don't have that. All right. You mind giving this a little rinse, Dad?
Yeah, no problem. If you need a little more.
All right, so we've got the parsley chopper. We're going to go ahead and get the fresh cloves of garlic chopped up. We're going to go ahead and add that into the meat. Dad's got the onions going. He said flips, Larry. Nice flips.
I was just checking.
He is a natural. He is a natural. That's where I get my skill from. It's a brilliant idea, and we should have started at Westwood in L.A. grad house. Oh, yeah? That's where you want me to start? I like it. I like it. Did Garrett come with you? No, Garrett didn't come with me. I wanted him to, but, you know, he's trying to pick up his Bumble game, guys. He's trying to get his Bumble game strong, you know what I'm saying? Let's go over to the onions with Pops for you guys while I do this. All right. I'm just kind of peeling the, you know, the top of the garlic off. I'm going to expose these cloves nice for you guys. I usually use the pre-peeled garlic, but last night we just went ahead and grabbed a clove of, you know, nice fresh head garlic. So I'm going to show you guys how I kind of peel it and break it down. So when you got your garlic, you know, skins on and everything, take your knife, give it a nice little crack, right? And it kind of breaks open and allows you to kind of pull everything off of it a lot easier, which is a pretty cool little trick I learned in culinary school. This is a fat head of garlic right here, a little fat clove of garlic. That's a nice size one. So probably going to use that. Maybe one more of the same size. While I do that, I'm going to go ahead and give you guys back to the cast iron while Pops is growing them up. You see the grill marks on the onions. Dad knows what he's doing.
Don't burn them.
Just getting the color. You mean the grinder game? Yeah, you know. Garrett's all over the place. It's hard to control what he's doing with his grinder and his Bumble. All right, so peeling off the garlic. We got a couple
cloves. The onion tells you when it's ready, too. The smell of the onion lets you know. You don't want to burn onion. It gets real bitter. But you can start smelling, like, the deep onion essence. You know it's time to flip it.
Absolutely.
It brings all the oil out.
Couldn't have said it any better. All right, so we got the garlic down. I'm going to go ahead and give it a mince. What I do is I kind of line the garlic with these little pre-cuts along the line. And then I'm going to go ahead and turn it, right, 90 degrees. And then mince. And then it kind of already does, like, a mini shortcutted mince already, so that way you don't have to start with like super big cuts and work down. So I got that kind of pre-cut, so let's do the same thing to this one. Nice pre-cut, turn 45 degrees, and then just mince along the side, right? Okay, now that we got that down, you're gonna keep it together. We're gonna do the same thing as the parsley, guys, just kind of give it a nice rough chop. Always keep the garlic all there so it's all getting, you know, evenly cut. Right. Now the garlic is very, very, very pungent, right? Fresh garlic is super strong. So when you're adding flavors like fresh garlic and fresh Italian parsley, we're going to go ahead and throw some salt, some pepper, some fresh dry chopped onion along with a little bit of garlic powder. And we're also going to go ahead and throw an egg in there, which adds a super, super nice texture and a nice shine to the burger. So when you go ahead and grill it, it gets like really, really, really nice marks on it. Yeah, we'll go ahead for the amount of meat we're going to be using tonight, guys. We're going to go ahead and use 2 eggs. We're doing about 4 pounds of meat, so 2 eggs is about perfect. My level of egg is like for about a pound of burger, I'll try to do about a half an egg. Or like, yeah, exactly. Or like a small egg. Or you can get like a couple quail eggs if you want to get crazy with it.
We don't do small eggs in this house. We just do the big jumbos here.
S. Canepa 77. I can't believe they allowed this shit on the internet. How much product is in Larry's hair? Uncle Steve, thanks for stopping by. I love it. Garrett, I got some cute friends I can introduce you to. Kaylee, just make sure they have a penis, all right? Thank you. All right, so onions are looking good. Pops is flipping those. They're cooking down real nice.
Nice, yeah, perfect.
see a little more.
Yeah, no,
that's good. You can see all the oils.
Looking good. Yeah.
Okay.
All right, guys. So I got my garlic. I got my parsley chopped. So we're going to go ahead and get down to the meat. All right. So I got the meat here, guys. All right. We got our meat. I'm going to go ahead and grab the eggs real quick for you guys.
I got them already.
Oh, where'd you put them?
I put them
right there. Oh, perfect. Yeah. All right. You already got the eggs out, so we're going to go ahead. We're going to put our eggs in. Almost like we're doing a meatloaf. Okay.
Ah.
If there's a sub, do they both drink? Well, I got me a nice Pacifico over here, so I'm going to be sipping on that. Go ahead and, you know, take some pounds for that. We figure it out,
actually,
guys. We'll see what happens when the subs.
The old Smokey off.
All right. Well, if you guys want to go ahead and sub, Dad's got a little surprise. He's going to pull out the old Smokey Tennessee salt caramel flavored whiskey. This stuff's delicious. I tried it last night. It's almost like a dessert whiskey. Super delicious. You could drink this shit on the rocks real easy. Go ahead and put that back here for now.
Yeah.
All right. So back to the... Not a sip, Drew, a shot. Oh, my God, Garrett, don't even get me started. She might be referring to you. Someone made father-son shot happen. All right, guys, so we got our burger. We got our egg applied. I'm going to go ahead and take about half the parsley I chopped. Go ahead and throw that on top, right? Take about half the garlic as well, and then we'll work in after we mix it a little bit. So you got half about the garlic, half parsley. I'm gonna give my hands a quick little rinse, guys. Okay. All right. So we got those plied in. I'm gonna go back to the pan for you guys.
Cam.
You can see Pop's doing the onions. We got
onion cam
going. And right when you get done with those onions, Dad, you can go ahead and start on those sweet potatoes.
All
right. Right. So we got our meat. We got our egg. We got our parsley. We got our garlic. Next. Fresh ground black pepper.
With a little coriander in it.
Does have a little bit of coriander seed in there that my dad put, so it already gets like a nice little extra bit of strong flavor from that coriander, which is super delicious. Nice complement to pepper.
Sometimes when I go to visit Uncle Steve, I get some of his pink peppercorns and put them in there too.
Pink peppercorn's delicious. A lot sweeter as far as all the peppercorns. Definitely a lot sweeter. Go ahead and apply some salt in there, guys. Always want to season up. Okay. We got some chopped onion. Now these are dried chopped onions, so they're almost like onion flake. I like putting them in burgers because when they cook in, they kind of soften up, and they add like a super, super delicious, like almost like crunch to the burger. So we're gonna go ahead and put like, oh no, around a tablespoon to a tablespoon and a half in there right now. I'm just gonna kind of eye it. So you got our fresh chopped onion. I'll go back over to the onion cam for you guys. See Dad get down. And we also got the fresh ground garlic that I'm going to go ahead and put in there. Basically just chunks of dried garlic clove that you can grind yourself so it kind of stays a little bit bigger, which then again adds more flavor. All right. Apply some salt. We always add salt. Paradon, thanks for stopping by. Tartar. All right, so we got our ingredients in here. I left a little bit of parsley and garlic out because I'm going to kind of mix it around and see. So I'm going to go ahead and take my watch off. I'm going to go ahead and mix up the meat for you guys. So I just use my hands. They are washed clean. Do not use dirty hands when you do this. Get people you're cooking for sick. It's no cool. So the egg adds like a nice slimy texture to it. You really want to mix it in as much as you can. Get all those seasonings thrown in there. We got Dad on the mandolin right now, slicing up the sweet potatoes.
Just getting a few sliced so I can...
Getting a couple sliced going. So I'm going to go ahead and keep mixing this meat up. Yeah, like I said, you guys can go ahead and use, command recipe, exclamation recipe. It's going to pull up the command for all the ingredients tonight, guys. So I'm really mixing it around, making sure all the ingredients get spread out. You really want to go ahead and also mix the two meats really well together. So everyone's getting like a nice, you know, equal 50-50 of the elk and the bison. Right, guys. So from what I see, I do need to add a little bit more parsley and a little bit fresh chopped garlic, or fresh chopped garlic, and I am going to go ahead and add more of the seasonings as well. So
do you want to add oil into that at all because it's lean, or do you just want
to
go?
No, we don't need to add oil. We're gonna you know have the skillet seasoned up with oil anyway, so we'll be good on that. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go wash my hands real quick, guys. We're gonna add the rest of the seasonings. We're gonna mix it back in, and then the meat will be ready to go. We'll form the patties up, and then we'll get started on everything else. Perfect chips coming out. He's got going right now. All right, guys.
Always wash your hands. Sanitation is the number one thing in cooking, guys. Always got to keep your hands sanitized. Soap, water, raw meat. No bueno. Don't get your people sick.
Andrew handles Garrett and meat the same way. Oh, my Lord. You guys are hilarious. Wash the hands. Exactly. Garrett's getting all worked up. Supreme Jesus, Denver, what's going on, my dude? How you doing tonight, man? Thanks for stopping by the stream. Appreciate it very much. So like I said, guys, I'm going to go ahead and add the rest of these ingredients. I'm going to probably put like a couple more handfuls of parsley in there, maybe a little bit more. Okay, we're going to add the rest of that fresh chopped garlic. Remember, it was two decent-sized cloves, about the size of a silver dollar. Those cloves with the thick, you know, about the thickness of four of them. So those were just enough garlic. I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit more pepper. Pepper really, really, really goes well on a burger. A lot of pepper, just like a steak, right? Beef needs pepper. All right.
Turkey burgers really need pepper.
Especially turkey burgers. Oh, yeah. You got to make some turkey burgers. Go ahead and throw a lot of pepper in there. It's going to be like the key ingredient. So we got a little bit more salt. We're going to go ahead and add a little bit fresh chopped onion in there. Dry fresh onion. Okay, and finish it off with some fresh ground garlic. Go ahead back to the onion can for you guys. See Dad getting that last onion in.
The stubborn one.
And then, Dad, after you do that onion, you can go ahead and just turn the grill down to low.
You got it.
Let all the fat stay in there and the onion flavor, and just turn it on low and let it sit so we get those burgers ready.
And I would do that now.
Right now. My day's going well. Thank you, Denver. Just up in Colorado visiting the family. Have a nice vacation. Looking forward to doing the app with my dad this whole week. Actually, since last week. So, it's finally happening. I'm a happy man. Happy man. Alright, guys. So, we got the meat going. Dad's over next to me on the mandolin, as you guys can see, slicing the potatoes. Nice. Perfect, perfect size. Alright, guys. So, you're looking for almost like
16th of an inch.
16th of an inch. Yeah. Almost like paper thin, right? But super consistent along the entire sweet potato. He's going to go ahead and slice all the sweet potatoes we got, and he's going to go ahead and put them in water, which is going to stop the oxidizing of the potato, but it's also, as you soak them in the water, it's going to kind of clean them off, wash them off, take the bitterness out, eat it raw. Yeah, we'll do like a bison elk tartare. No, thank you. I'm good.
That would not be very good. The elk wouldn't. The bison seriously would be okay.
Yeah, the bison would be all right. Elk would be a little too much. Alright guys, so we got the meat all mixed up. So what we're going to do is I'm going to wash my hands. I'm going to get a platter out. We're going to form seven delicious, perfectly portioned out patties. The kids will have a couple smaller patties, so you know, we'll sneak the extra meat into me and Pop's burgers.
Know,
and you know, Nate might need that double tonight, so we'll see if we have enough for an eighth patty, because I know Nate be eating. I don't got Garrett to feed tonight. I don't got my special guest that wants to eat the dish at the end of the night. Last week we had Maddie. We got to get an in on it. So, like I said, guys, if you want to hit me up, you want to come by and taste the dish one night, go ahead and let me know. We got something scheduled up. I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands, guys. Watch Dad kind of finish up on the mandolin. And I'll be back in one sec, guys.
All right. Jump in here.
Doing good?
Yeah, doing good. Down? Almost down to the nub here. I got the little safety feature, so I don't cut my fingers. These mandolin blades are amazingly sharp.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Once I get down a little lower, I'm gonna throw that thing in there and make sure I stay.
Yeah, these mandolins are super, super sharp,
yeah,
guys.
Yeah, so this one's a Pampered Chef. It was, you know, kind of one of those things that my wife Jenny picked up at one of those Pampered Chef parties. But this thing is fantastic. I've used it for so many different things.
All right, so. We're not gonna get like a tray to put these burger patties on. Something bigger, so I just use like another cutting board or something.
You want a
just some sort of sheet. Yeah, that'd be perfect.
You want some parchment or oil? That top door or
right here?
That one right there.
Right here?
Yeah, cool.
Alright guys, I'm just gonna get a tray. Go ahead and lay down some parchment on there. Your part's in the blue?
Yeah. Right there, yeah.
Alright, so we're gonna lay some parchment paper down. We got our parchment on our pan. Go ahead, put the meat there. All right, we got our parchment on our tray. So what I'm gonna do is, you have spray, like oil spray?
I do, yeah.
Pan, fine.
That's fine.
So we're just gonna go ahead and put a little spray down on the baking sheet. That way the meat doesn't kind of stick to it after I make the patties. Go ahead and give that a little spray. All right. So we're gonna go ahead and make our patties, guys. Smelfy forced cream down my throat. How's it going, man? Thanks for stopping by. Rob says Uncle Larry. What's going on,
what's
Rob?
Up,
thanks
Rob?
For stopping by.
What's going on, buddy?
All right, guys. So we're gonna get these burger patties going. I'm trying to catch up and chat with you guys. All right. So let's go ahead and get these going, guys. We're gonna take our meat. All right. Get some good sized burger patties. Probably like, I'd say this right here, you're looking about almost like an 8-ouncer, like almost about a half pounder based on how heavy it is. We need to make 7 burgers, so we're gonna get our patties going down. If you feel like it's a little bit too big, don't hesitate to rip it off. What I like to do is I like to almost like form them into like little balls, guys, right? And then that way you just kind of push it down. See how big your patty is, right? So we got a couple big patties down for the burgers. You know, tend to shrink when you cook them. So one way you can avoid that is by pushing the center down. Inside the center, push down, and it'll stop it from kind of sinking in. But they're still gonna naturally do it. So you still want to make your burgers, you know, pretty big when you do them, because they are gonna shrink up. So the bigger the better. You kind of push them down and let them kind of scoop up and absorb in, but they'll still be decent size. All right. We're getting our third burger patty down. This one's kind of big, so I'm going to go ahead and pull a little bit of meat off that. Reform it after I take the meat off just to get the shape right. Press down.
You know, if I'm in your way at all,
you're good. You're not even supposed to be in your way. Okay, so we got 3 down.
Some big curvy potatoes.
Got some big old patties too for the boys. We got three good sized ones for me, Nate, and my dad. For the girls, we'll go ahead and make them a little bit thinner. Not thinner, a little bit smaller in general. So that's about like a normal size burger right there by the time it shrinks up and everything. Probably like a nice little 6-7 ouncer. When you get into the 8 ounces, that's when they start to get real, real heavy. So we got the mandolin slicing up all the sweet potatoes. We got 3, you know, 7 to 8 inch sweet potatoes, about as, 2.5-3 inches wide. Slicing those down into nice little, you know, size chips. All right. So we got. We're gonna have the adults' burgers on this tray ready to go. We'll make a couple smaller patties for the girls. All right. It's not the size that matters. It's bigger the better. Yeah, you know what they say. It's going down like Young Jock. Old school song right there.
Yeah, it is.
Dad knows about that song. All right. All right, so we got the adult patties down here. Dad, you mind grabbing me just a small, well, just for the girls' burgers, just need
a little
room
pig.
For just 2 more burgers. Yeah, just 2 more burgers for the girls.
that around like that.
Yeah, perfect. A little parsley. Sorry, scoop that up. Take care of that after.
There we go.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and get the girls, my younger sister's burgers, ready. Oh, you want to go ahead and spray it up?
Yeah.
While I form this, he's going to go ahead and get a little piece of parch, spray it so the burgers don't stick. These are perfect little burgers for the girls compared to the big boys, right? It's like about half the size. Less in trouble. All right. We got my sister's burgers about to go down on the pan as well. Right. Perfect. I've got these down. So we got all our burgers made. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We actually have 8 burgers. I did make a little extra one for Nate if he wants to get on that double. Boy, be eating. All right, so we got our burgers. I'm going to go ahead and get this bowl out of the way.
Wash my hands up. Stay sanitized. Got raw meat all over me. Dad's getting those sweet potatoes finished up. We're going to get those frying. Get them all crispy, toss them with some seasoning, so I'll be ready to go for the burgers when we get those all cooked up. After he's done slicing up the sweet potato, he's going to go ahead and he's going to take the sweet Gouda, the smoked Gouda we got, cheese. Dad, you want to hand me one of those bricks of cheese so I can go ahead and show them what they look like?
That's
going to be real good, guys. If you haven't had smoked Gouda, it's one of my favorite cheeses.
It's crazy.
You can legitimately smell the smokiness of the cheese. I mean, through the plastic, it's unbelievable. Smoked Gouda, super, super delicious. Comes in a quarter wheel. He's gonna go ahead and make some nice slices up. We're gonna get those melted on top of the burgers. Real, real good. Super smoky, guys, and super melty as well. Some cheese, you know, you might be trying out different cheeses. You gotta make sure you know which ones melt, because certain cheeses won't melt down. They'll kind of stay clumpy and dry. And you want a good cheese like Gouda, cheddar, mozzarella, those kind of cheeses melt, break down nice and creamy. Super, super delicious. Yo, your dad is working out them tries. Yes, gluten-free bun. Alyssa's not going to be eating gluten-free bun tonight. She's going to be eating it like a steak. Plenty of flavor to eat it like that. Z Toodles looks tasty. I got a recommendation for something you can make. Absolutely. I'll take any recommendation you guys have to offer. Z Toodles, if you want to go ahead and message in charge, 087, you can kind of @ him, directly message him or whatever, give him the recommendation, and then after I'm done, I can, you know, look at the recommendations you guys have to offer, we'll get episodes set up with them, I can reach out to you, and, you know, we can figure out, you know, what we want to do, and you could even be a star taster if you want to, be a guest taster. Jen, Auntie Jen, thanks for stopping by, she said hi, Uncle Larry.
Hey, Jen.
I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to get some pepper on these burgers, again on the top, because can't season these things enough with salt and pepper. Dad's finishing them up, some sweet potatoes.
Got one.
We got our pepper down, we'll do a little bit more salt on there. Thanks again, guys, for everyone that came out tonight, has been supporting the stream. We're pretty much 2 weeks into the stream. We got 5 episodes out. You guys have been phenomenal with the support. I appreciate it so much, guys. If you're new tonight and you're enjoying your time, go ahead and hit the follow button up at the screen. I'm gonna say it's like right over here somewhere. Go ahead and follow the channel. You'll get your notification when we go live. Follow the Twitter, follow the Facebook, follow the Instagram. A little thicker.
Yeah, I can. I adjusted the thing a little bit.
We can do those last. Okay. I'm kind of cook longer.
Okay.
Go ahead. Got weekly updates on everything, pictures of everything. We're really, you know, growing quick, and it's because of you guys. So thank you so much, guys. I can't say it enough. So I'm going to go ahead and get these burgers out of the way real quick. We're going to get these marked up in just a second, guys. So Dad's going to get the cheese going right after he gets the potatoes. I'm going to go ahead and throw these in the bowl of water now.
Yeah, go for it.
Over here. You got a bowl of water. That should be plenty after that.
Okay, that's
yeah, we got a lot of potato.
Okay, we're done. Yeah,
done. That should be plenty.
Okay.
So we got all our potatoes. We're gonna go ahead and get them in some water.
Look at these cool shaped ones.
Nice. Get this out of the way. Okay, get these soaked up. So what happens with things like potatoes? Basically, once you once you cut open into them and you open them up, they will start to oxidize after a while, which means they start to get brown like a banana, right? You open a banana and they sit too long, they start to get brown. Well, that's because they're oxidizing. So a way of avoiding potatoes from oxidizing, if you want to pre-cut them, you want to make a big batch of mashed potatoes, whatever you're doing, cube potatoes, whatever it is, and you want to get them done ahead of time, just put them in a bucket of water completely submerged under, and they're going to stop the oxidation process, and they're going to keep them fresh for you guys the next time you want to cook them. Oh, my Lord. For open the fresh Gouda, I could smell it the second he pulled it out. Got like a nice crosshatch mark on it. I mean, it's this thing, I want to eat it off the brick. It's unbelievable.
You want the slices this way?
yeah, long slices. Get them nice, ready to cover up the whole burger. Larry, you were just a mic, Uncle Steve said. Some sort of my high club, but inside of airplane. Oh my God, you guys are killing me. You guys just crack me up. All right, so we got the sweet potatoes soaking. What's going to happen is after I get about through half the burgers, I'm going to go ahead and have my dad he's going to take them out after he's done with the cheese. He's going to press them in a towel. He's going to get all the liquid out because, as many of you know, oil and water don't mix very well together. So if you put a bunch of things that have water on it inside a deep fryer, oil is going to be spraying and shooting all over the place. And it's super scary, super dangerous, could cause a grease fire, hit you in the eye, burn up your arms. You guys want to stay away from that.
I think people have probably heard the frozen turkey story.
Absolutely, right? Absolutely. So, yeah, make sure you get all that moisture out of there, guys. Do not put anything that has a lot of water on it in a fryer, in any sort of oil. We got Smelfy coming through with a follow. Thank you very much for the follow, man. I appreciate it very much. You guys have been, awesome. Clutch City, thanks for stopping by. Clutch City 28, thanks for coming by, man. Supporting the stream, appreciate it. So I'm going to do, guys... So I'm going to go ahead and get this cast iron grill heated up once again, all right? It's been on a low temperature. We're going to go ahead and turn it up.
And that low temperature let all that onion oil and everything just kind of season the heck out of it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go ahead and I'm gonna put it on about medium heat. Let this pan kind of heat up a little bit. It was on low to kind of keep all the oils that released off the red onion in there. There's ways of seasoning your grill. You can always spray it. You could get a rag of oil and kind of rub it. Or you could do things like rubbing a raw onion on there. Or you can cook, like my dad and I just did, the grilled red onion on there before. And it kind of just seasons the pan completely with all the natural oils that are released. Super, super awesome, and does add like a little bit of flavor. You guys are out of control. Gosh, you guys are out of control. All right, so we got the pan heating up. We're going to get these burgers thrown on there, guys. These cast irons retract a lot of heat, so even as far as grabbing something like the handle right here, no bueno, because it's hot throughout the entire pan. So make sure you guys got towels. My dad over here has a warm pad right here, a heat pad, so I can grab it if I need to. These pans get super hot, so if you're messing with cast irons, make sure you're staying safe. You're not burning your hands up. I'm going to go ahead, drop a couple burgers down, guys. Let's see where we're at with heat. All right. Got a nice sizzling sound. Throw the burgers down. Now I'm throwing them down on the side that I did the salt and pepper already. So you put that side down, and then once you have the exposed side up, I'm gonna go ahead and put a little bit more salt and pepper. You wanna keep the beef nice and seasoned. You really need, especially with these gamey meats, to really put that seasoning in there and keep it flavored up, or else you're gonna get that gaminess. Bandis, thanks for stopping by. Can we do a cooking pot show while you're out in Colorado? That's gonna be on 420 on the YouTube. We're not gonna do a live stream with that. Too many young ones kind of tuning in with the fam and stuff like that, so we're not going to be doing that. Beerus, oh my God. you know it.
That can be enough to eat.
That should be plenty. Okay. Yeah, that should be plenty. We got the burgers down, guys. I'm going to wash the raw meat off my hand. I'm going to season up the rest of the burgers. Dad's got the cheese all sliced up. We got some nice long, you want to go ahead and show them?
Sure.
Cheese.
Got the nice sliced Gouda. The smoky flavor, I took a little bite because I had to cheat a little bit. Fantastic. I mean, the Gouda's creaminess is amazing. When you add the smoke flavor in there, it's a knockout. These are going to be so good on these burgers.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and get a little salt and pepper on these babies. keep them seasoned. Dad's kind of rotating the potatoes. Maybe a couple minutes. Go ahead and pull them out. Get all that off. And then do like a test fry just to get an idea of how long they're going to be.
You got it.
When you guys fry, you got to keep in mind the more you put of something in the oil, the higher the oil rises. So always be careful with your oil
and the temperature
quantity. And then the temperature also goes down with the more you put in there. So it's always a good idea to kind of do a test fry of something, chicken, whatever you're doing. It's always safe to give a test fry. It gives you a better idea of, you know, how you need to adjust, whatever, wire it down. Just missed the first 250 minutes of the stream. Well, thanks for dropping by, Mars McCoy. You've been here since the first episode. I appreciate it very much. Holly, I see you, girl. Thanks for stopping by. Why so serious with what, Uncle Steve? All
right, so we got the burgers down. Smelling real, real good. I'm going to go ahead and...
This whole house is going to smell good.
And see what we're working here as far as color. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the heat up just a little bit. Want to get a nice crust on these burgers, guys.
Nice crust. That's where all the flavor develops.
So you can see that the water's turned cloudy in here.
Let's see. So as you can see, just from being in here, which you can see pretty clearly, guys, the color of the water becomes super cloudy and brown. That's just everything coming off of this potato. It's really doing a good job of cleaning it off, getting all the, you know, the dirt and all the really bitter taste of the potato out. It's just really nice. So that's why you always want to soak these up. As far as, you know, taking away the oxidation as well, that's the main thing, but it really does help clean them up. The way your dad talked about cheese, you know that boy loves cheese. Can you smell it? You can smell it in the basement. Well, that's a great sign.
Nice.
Nate said it smells in the basement. So go ahead and give us one more minute, Dad.
Okay.
Get them popped out. Do your test fry. We're going to let these burgers go. We got our grilled red onion, guys. They look delicious.
We got these ready. What we're going to do is at the, you know, right before serving time, we'll take them. We'll nuke them real quick just to get a little bit of heat on them. Warm them up just a tad bit, and they're going to go ahead and get on the burger. I'm going to show you guys how we're going to spread the bun, slice the bun, spread the bun, get those ready to get toasted. You by toasting the mustard and the mayonnaise into the bun, it really takes like that flavor to a different level. Like it's unbelievable. It pushes the mustard in, and you can really taste it in the bite. It's unbelievable. In Charge donated $20. You better get little sister some dessert while you're there. Thank you for the $20 donation, Max. You've been shooting bits at me every stream. The donation, that's amazing. Thank you so much. You guys are seriously killing me. Nate Dog coming in with 500 bits. Thank you guys for the tip. Seriously, thank you so much. You guys are out of control. Holly is on the phone with Liz. All right, back to the burgers, guys.
So we're going to be marking them off two by two, right? We got some big old burgers down. Oh, yeah, we're getting some real nice grill marks on these babies, which you guys will see in a moment. Oh, yeah, looking good. So the thing with burgers, guys,
that a lot of people don't realize, first and foremost, do not ever, 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 ever take a burger and push your spatula down on it and shoot out all the grease. What you're doing is you're taking all that flavor that's inside that burger and you're just pushing it out and you're making it dry and you're taking all the delicious moisture and grease out of it. Grease is delicious in a burger. Like, do not do that. Secondly, do not flip your hamburger 120 times. That's the stupidest thing you can do when making a burger. Hypothetically, when you make a burger, all you should do is have it on one side. All right, you start at a 90-degree angle. You rotate to another 90-degree angle. That's how you get those cross hash marks. All right, and then you flip it over, 90-degree angle, and then back to a 90-degree angle. You have your cheese or whatever you're putting on there to melt, and that's it. It should finish on that side. The more you're flipping, no, don't do not do that. Do not do that. Rob, I love seeing you in here. Thanks for stopping by. You guys got the girls watching, Holly and Rhee. I hope they're tuning in as well. Love those little girls. 119 is okay. Damn, that's why. So Dad's over here. He's taking the sweet potatoes off. He's pressing them between paper towels, and he's getting all that moisture out, like I said to do. Make sure we got none of that water thrown in there. Yeah.
You want me to test just a handful of them?
It's up to you. Yeah, you can do whatever. I mean.
Okay.
Let's get that test. All right, guys. So we're going to go ahead. We're going to check and see if it's ready time to flip.
You know when the burger is doing good because all around right here, it starts to turn like a darker maroony color, and you can kind of see the juices poking through. And that means we're getting close to flip time. So I'm going to take this burger, right? And I'm just going to go ahead and rotate it. in the pan. Okay. Give it a nice 45 degree rotation.
Cross that.
All right. And I'm just going to, like I said, I'm not going to push the juices out, but I'm just going to push down so we can develop those hash marks by, you know, making sure the entire piece of beef is hitting that.
I'm using the mini here.
Okay, so Dad's got the, go ahead and show him. We got the mini deep fryer, guys. We got the basket. He's just going to go ahead and do a test with a couple of the potatoes just to see how long they take, how hot much the deep fryer pops.
Oh, good. Yeah.
So he's going to go ahead and drop those in. We're going to do a test fry, figure out how long it's going to take for the potatoes to come to a perfect temperature, whether he's got to do them in batches. I'd probably do them in batches. Might be a little bit easier.
Yeah, they'll stick together.
Yeah, they tend to stick. You need like a certain tool to kind of wand them around and separate them. It's kind of a hassle. So do them in batches if you don't got like a super big fryer. It's not like an industrial thing. Drew, some people are stuffing the inside of their burgers with cheese these days. Can that change a cook time? No, I've noticed that too. That has become like a huge trend in the burger world is stuffing it with like chilies and cheese. And no, it doesn't necessarily change the cook time. The cheese just kind of melts out. If anything, I would think it would be faster. I have only done it a couple times and I didn't really notice a significant difference. The only thing I could think of as far as that would be the cheese melting inside is going to create like a hotter temperature inside the burger, so it might cook a little bit quicker. That's just like kind of my take on it. I don't do that too much. I have done it in the past, but, you know. All right, guys, so we're going to go ahead, look at the burgers, see how these marks are coming out. Oh, yeah, we're looking good. Pull it out real quick. Yeah. All right, so we got some nice color. I'm going to do a quick flip. Got a nice little crust on there. The bigger one right here is going to go ahead and be a little bit longer. That one's got a nice color on it. All right, looking good. Go ahead. Yeah. You want them to crunch up. I'm just trying to think. You might need to. Well, the more we put in there, the oil will. It won't be as hot.
Yeah.
Yeah, but see how they're curling like that. Yeah. Perfect. Okay. Just like potato chip consistency.
Gotcha. Okay.
Perfect. So burgers are going. We're doing them in batches. We got a nice cast iron skillet. If you guys weren't here earlier, brings a lot of heat in there. Makes beautiful crust on the meat. I really recommend cooking your expensive meats, a ribeye. Porterhouse, a New York. You do that in a cast iron, develops great flavor. Drew, should show us Italians how to make some real scratch marinara. Yes, Rob, that's going to be on one of my upcoming episodes. I would love to teach. I'm very excited to show you guys how to make my marinara recipe. I cooked marinara sauce over at the Country Club for a long, like pretty much every week that I worked there for pasta night. I was making marinara, so I really got down to making it. I really learned to love to make it. Really learned how to, you know, add my own touch to it. Doing it at home, doing it there. So I will be doing a marinara episode for you guys. Absolutely, most likely with my scratch made pasta, which I cannot wait to show you guys. So back to the burgers, guys. Go ahead and check this big daddy. Get a flip. Oh yeah, we've got a beautiful crust on there, guys. Beautiful, beautiful crust. I'm gonna go ahead and move these over. I'm gonna go ahead and throw a third one on there since we got the room. Get it going. So with the burger, you kind of test it with your finger. If you want to use a thermometer, that's fine. I use my finger. I've kind of gotten it down. You can kind of tell the cooking. I'm gonna go ahead and throw some cheese on there, Dan.
So what I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna kind of cook the burgers right before mid-rare. We're going to get them ready. Since we're doing them in batches, what we're going to do is we're going to take them. We have an oven that's off. I'm going to go ahead and throw the burgers in the oven, let them rest, and the oven's, you know, consolidated, so it's going to keep all that heat in there from the burger, and it's really not going to allow them to cool down much. So go ahead and throw a couple slices of the smoke on there. Perfect. Alright. You got cheese down on the burgers, guys. That smoked gouda is looking real, real good. You can smell it once it starts to melt. Unbelievable.
Oh, man. That's crazy.
Yeah. I think they'll be a little less dark the more you put in there.
Yeah.
Just because the oil is so hot. We got our test run down. The sweet potatoes are tasting delicious. They came out a little bit darker, but that's because we just put a small batch of them in. The more you put in, the less hot the oil is going to be, so they'll cook a lot better. They do taste delicious. Not a poncho. We'll be wearing a sombrero to make pico de gallo more authentic. Well, that's up to you, man. Apple pie burger? No, thank you. Alright. Got our burgers in. Cheese is starting to melt up on them real nice. We're going to kind of let them go.
We're going to throw them in the oven, like I said, guys. We're going to let the cheese kind of finish melting on them. Let them rest while we get the other ones marked off. We're looking good.
Yeah, yeah, you can go ahead and get them done.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, just go ahead and do them in batches and okay. Get them done.
Alright. So based on the bounce that I'm feeling from these burgers, we're getting real close to mid-rare, so I'm about to take them off in a second, throw them in the oven, let them rest, let them cool while we get the rest of the burgers marked off.
We're going to get those buns cut up for you guys. We're going to spread them. We're going to toast them. After that, we'll get the avocado sliced up. We'll have the potatoes, sweet potato chips ready to go. We're going to season them up right when we take them out of the oil. You always want to go ahead and season them right away while they still have a little bit of oil on them, because all the seasonings you throw on them are going to kind of stick, and that way it really helps season them up a little bit more. It's cheese. Yes, it's cheese. It's smoked Gouda cheese that my dad sliced by hand.
All right, so
I need a little pan.
All right, so I'm going to take the burgers with the cheese.
So we got our burgers. I'm just gonna throw them in the oven. Let the cheese finish melting. Let the burgers carry over and rest. Perfect. We need a couple more burgers on for you guys.
I'm not gonna do them too thick of a layer because I don't want them to stick together. So I'm just kind of doing a thin layer, and I'm gonna kind of stir them around as they're frying, keep them from sticking, and also make sure that there's not one side that's cooking faster than the other. So nice color on these, though. Beautiful orange on these.
Right, so we got the burgers down. I put one burger in there, one new burger. Like I said, they're big. They shrink up. So by the time that second one shrinks up, we'll throw a third one in there. The girls' burgers will cook up nice and quick because they're a little bit smaller. By the time that's done, sweet potatoes will be done. We're going to get these buns, like I said, sliced up for you guys in a second. I'm going to show you guys how I do that.
We get a little bowl out of here.
Yeah, go right ahead.
We're gonna season them.
You could turn the oil down just a little bit.
Maybe go to like 325.
Okay. All right, hands are washed. We're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna get started on the
buns for you guys, right? Brioche buns, if you guys missed it earlier. Super soft, super delicious, amazing flavor in brioche if you guys haven't had brioche before. A couple other things you could use brioche for: if you get a whole brioche loaf, you could slice it up and make French toast with it. It's out of this world, out of this world. One of my favorite things that we did in culinary school, absolutely. Catch up with you guys real quick. Cheese and friends, oh, you know it, Jackie. Not a lot of people know about that. Type out the cheese wrap, I love it. Alyssa would be so embarrassed. All right, so back to the burgers.
Oh, yeah, those are looking perfect. Perfect. All right, guys, look at the crust on this baddie. Oh, yeah. You can even see the fresh parsley and garlic kind of oozing out of it. It's unbelievable. It's so delicious. Okay. Kind of make some room for another patty to go down. There we go. One more patty in there. Wash the hands. Stay in sanitary all night, baby.
We're going to go ahead and put a little bit more seasoning on there for you guys. Yeah, Gmo, I know you heard that, baby. Damn, Drew killing it again with the show. Looks so good. Thanks, Dan. Thanks for stopping by, brother. Always appreciate it. I'm glad you're here.
All right, guys, let me go ahead and season the burgers. A little more salt, a little more pep.
The other one's just about ready to flip.
Dad's got the chips going. They're looking real good. Perfect, nice gold color. Oh, yeah, this.
They're looking good. Dad, you could even line the bowl with paper towel.
Yeah, that's what I do at my first time.
But so right when you take them out, take some of that that cumin and a little bit of that salt.
Okay. And just kind of sprinkle it over and toss them. As far as the coriander.
Does this have a grinder built into it or no?
No.
Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and just
smash it. Some Lowry's seasoned salt, your favorite?
I like Lowry's, not with these. So I'm just going to get these coriander seeds kind of... Let me wash this off.
Burger is smelling real good, though.
I was looking for my mortar and pestle. I can't find it.
It's all good. Garlic sticking to the knife. There we go. All right.
So, since we got some whole coriander seed, I'm just going to go ahead and give them a crush with the back of the knife. All right, we got our coriander seeds down, taking a knife, and we're just kind of working them with the knife. Now, since they're whole coriander, and I'm doing that, it's going to have a lot more flavor than, you know, just the regular ground up coriander, because they're from whole, a lot more pungent flavor. So I'm going to go ahead and give that to my dad. I'm going to go ahead and put this right here, and you can kind of scoop
it. Oh, you got it.
You don't need much of the coriander. That stuff is super, super strong. I can already smell it pretty much throughout the whole kitchen. It's insane. All right, back to the burgers. I have a couple slices of cheese pop.
You got it.
We're going to put cheese on this, Daddy. We got cheese on this one. We're going to go ahead and get this one, which had been rotated around, flipped over. Got a nice crust on this one.
I think these are done right here. But...
Oh, yeah. They're looking good. Give them a sec to sit and see how crispy they get. If they don't get quite crisp enough, you can throw them a little bit more, yeah. Just going to rotate that burger, guys. See, we're getting the crosshatch marks on there. You want the nice crust, adds delicious flavor. You go ahead and grab me the brioche buns, Deb.
You got it.
Aria says hi, Drew. Hi, Aria. Hi, sweetheart. Thanks for watching, girl. Miss you. Auntie says hi. Auntie Smoothie. Maxie, Garrett, everyone's saying hi to you, Aria. Alyssa, baby Ree. So, my sister's gluten-free. She's one of those psychos. So, she won't be eating one of these delicious... golden brioche buns. Get the best angle. These things are fire, guys. I mean, just the best flavor. Just so delicious. So I'm going to go ahead and slice these up. So we got, what, how many burger buns? Six tonight for us? Am I using a bun?
Yeah.
Dad, can you grab me that pan out the oven real quick with the burgers? We're going to go ahead and...
This one?
There's one in the oven, yeah. We're gonna throw this on there. Okay, go ahead. Toss it back in there. Alright.
You want this on at all? Like a super low?
Yeah, you go ahead and turn it on like the lowest of the low. Yeah.
I'll
do
a convection 170, it'll be
rolling. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw a little bit more cheese on the burger. Alright. We're getting down to the last three burgers, guys. And go ahead and throw another one on there. Yeah, crunchier the better. All right, so we got cheese on that one. We got a couple more. The last two adult burgers down. And then we're going to go ahead and throw the girls' burgers on. We're going to cook them a little bit more for the kiddos. You know, they don't need to be eating medium rare that young, even though I know my sisters like it. Lady and Famous 415, Drew Cooking. How's it going, lady? I don't know if I know who you are. You want to go ahead and say your name? If not, it's cool. Lady and Famous 14? I don't even know. Who want to see Drew take a shot? You know? If you sub, I'm taking a shot. So that's up to you guys. Go ahead and wash my hands, guys. Give you back a little burger view. Alright. Hands are washed up. We're going to get these burgers going. Said hi, Auntie Smoothie. I love Auntie Smoothie. Oh, a little Aria. Medium rare or well done for your burger? Well, I will never, ever, ever put them... a well done burger near my mouth. I'll tell you that right now. Unless it's at McDonald's. I'm a medium rare guy. Steaks, burgers, pork chops, I'll go medium to medium rare. I don't care. I love a soft pink center, as most of you know. So, medium rare all the way. The girls, we're going to go a little bit higher. I'm making, no bacon. Normally I put bacon on my burgers. I'm going to do another burger night for you guys of how I do like my typical ground beef burger. But for tonight we're doing the elk bison burger. You know, we're in Colorado. We're doing the theme burger. So we're going to go ahead and do that. I think this burger is just about ready to get taken off. So let's go ahead and check that out. Yeah. Grab my pan. No, it's good. I checked it. Mama didn't raise no bee.
Alright, so we're getting the last burger off. Add cheese. We're going to let these two finish. We're going to throw the girls on there.
Eat one of those. What are you going to try?
Burgers are resting up real good.
Eat one of those chips. They're real good.
All right. We got two burgers on. I'm going to go ahead and taste the chip.
Beautiful crunch. Beautiful crunch.
All right. Chips are looking good, guys.
We got a nice color. Did you toss them with seasoning yet, Pop?
I did, yeah.
Yeah. We toss them with a little bit of seasoning. They look just like, you know, regular old potato chips. They're looking real good. Tasting real delicious, guys. Perfect crunch. We're back to the burgers.
Check the side. Got a beautiful crust. This one just went down for like a little bit longer before you rotate it. Give it that little 45 degree. And then we'll get the girls' burgers going.
Like I said, we're gonna have to take the red onion. We're gonna reheat them. We can even throw them in the oven since it's a little bit warm, and just let them kind of stay warm before we put them on the burger. So I'm gonna go ahead and get these buns chopped up for you guys.
You're gonna show me your buns?
Yeah, you can see my buns. That boy Drew, Johnny Aliotti. Oh, okay, Johnny, I see you. Grab it by the horns and drag it across the grill. Exactly. What do we got here? Smelfy has subscribed with the Twitch Prime. Thank you very much for the Twitch Prime subscription, Smelfy. Go ahead and cheers it out to you. A lot cleaner than the Jameson, I'll tell you that.
Look at the moisture coming out of these things. Oh, yeah. Even after I towel them.
So yeah, as you can see, we got a lot of smoke coming. Even the moisture after picking them out of the towel, it still develops, you know, a pretty good reaction to the water, so that's why it's important. I'm gonna go ahead and slice the buns in half, nice and even, right down the middle. Usually I'd use a bread knife, but I'm not even worried about it tonight. It's nice and sharp. Okay, so we got our buns sliced up. Nice and even. Get these off to the side. Finish up the last two. Right, last one. You can go either way, guys. You can go down or up. You can go sideways. You can go this way, right? Put your hand on top, slice in, or put it sideways and just go right down. Either way, it's up to you. Whatever you feel more safe doing. A bread knife, like I said, is going to be a lot easier. It's really gonna slice through. This knife's pretty sharp, so it's pretty easy to go through. I love the onion raw on the burger. Raw onion's delicious too. I like raw onion as well, but for this burger, the sweetness, the oils coming out of the red onion are really gonna complement the burger. Bread knife right here, as you can see, it's gonna have the little bumps right here, serrated knife action right here, and that just goes through the bread a lot cleaner. He's got one. I didn't need it. Like I said, easy to go. I like my buns toasty. Absolutely. Always got to toast the bun because when you put the meat on, the juice, you know, starts to kind of go into the bread and it softens it up. So you want to make sure that you toast it up so it stays nice and crunchy. So we got the bun spread. We're going to go ahead and go over the burgers.
Burger cam. That one's about ready for some cheese. This one's ready for the flip. You guys see the nice crust on top there. We got our this one ready to go. Put a couple slices on there. That's good for that one.
Okay.
All right, so we're gonna let those go. We're gonna get the girls' burgers on in just a second. Those are gonna be going last. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys how I do the spread. So I take the little bowl. That's them.
You got it.
So you got the ground Dijonnaise mustard. We got your, you know, your typical mayo for you guys I didn't see earlier. Paul the Park just subscribed with another subscription. Thank you very much, Paul. Appreciate that very much. Give me one moment on that. So we got the whole grain Dijon, right? I'm going to do about a 50-50 on these. So I'm going to do about 2 tablespoons. Go ahead and do the cam over here, guys. Oh, wrong one. So we got, you know, 2 tablespoons worth in there. We're going to do about another 2 tablespoons worth of mayonnaise in there. Just going to mix that up real nicely with a spoon. This is called Dijonnaise for you guys. You can already buy it pre-made. I just make it myself, considering I have both ingredients at the house. All right. We got our Dijonnaise made. We're going to take it. Grab the buns. Dad, you want to go ahead and get another pan out that can stretch across these two?
Sure.
And we'll go ahead and toast the buns up on them. Okay. Go back to the burgers real quick. I'm going to go ahead and get that other burger off. I'm going to let the last one finish. Then we're going to get the girls' burger started last. I'm going to need that oven mitt, Dad, the hot pad.
Okay. I'm going to move this. We're going to pull this towel inside.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Pull
that over. All right.
Alright guys, so we got our burgers. They're sitting in the oven. They're resting up. The rest of the cheese melted down real nice, like this one will do. We got a nice, perfect temp on these babies. They're looking good. We're going to get these in the oven. Alright, we're going to get the girls' burgers thrown down. Alright, so we got the last 2 burgers. A little bit smaller, they're gonna cook a little bit longer. Alright. So we got the burgers down, the last of the burgers, guys. I'm gonna wash my hands real quick. Dad's finishing up on the sweet potato chip.
One more batch after this. So
one more batch, not too many, and we're done on those. Yeah. Alright, let's get these buns spread.
I'm gonna put the avos over here for you.
Yeah, you can put the avos over here. We'll do those. Okay. There was another subscriber, so I'm gonna do another one. But for now, after that, we're gonna go ahead and do the next 2 subs. We'll get another one. Thank you very much for the subscription, Paul of the Park. I appreciate it very much. I'm glad you're tuning in tonight. Benito says hi. What's going on, Benito? I miss you, buddy. Thanks for tuning in tonight, buddy. Thank you very much. When in doubt, go with 350. All right, guys. So we're going to go ahead and got the buns. We got bottoms. We got the tops. So we're just going to do a nice, right, nice little spread. Nothing crazy. A little bit. It's going to add delicious flavor to these burgers. A little Dijonnaise. 50-50. Right? 50-50 is the theme for the night. We got 50-50 elk bison. Got a little 50-50 on the Dijonnaise. Get these going. You got that skillet on, Pops?
It is, yeah.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. So I'm going to take the buns, guys. We're going to go ahead. And get a little hotter before I throw them on.
I can't put the middle burner. I don't want to put too high because I don't want to get that towel.
Oh, okay, I got you.
But this side, go ahead and crank it
on. The left side? Yeah.
Soldier Boy,
right or left?
Okay.
So yeah, turn that side up.
Yeah.
Let me get a little bit of that cheese, Dad. We're gonna throw the cheese rest on that burger, and then we got enough. We might need one more, like, quick slice for the girls' burgers.
Make it stop with those.
Yeah.
Yeah. There you go. There you go. Because it's kind of long for those burgers.
Do like that.
There we go.
Perfect. So we got cheese on that one. The girls' burgers are going. We're gonna let the skillet in the back. Heat up just a little bit more before we get these on, because we want them to get nice and toasty. Wyatt, what's going on, buddy? Thanks for tuning in with your dad, buddy. I miss you very much. Hope you're having a good night, dude. We'll see you at the restaurant soon, hopefully. Catch up with you guys real quick. Jason? We got Jason in here. Where's Jason at? Jason Cookier? Where's Jason at? If you're in there, Jason, thanks for stopping by, buddy. Miss you very much, man. Hope you're having a great time out in Seattle. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead. Pan's definitely gotten a lot hotter, so we're gonna go ahead and get these down. Let these kind of toast up, guys. We got the bottoms and the tops of these 3, and we'll get the rest going.
So we're gonna let these toast up. Burger's ready for the pan.
Got your hot pad somewhere right here. Alright, so we're gonna get the last burger in the oven to let the cheese melt, let it rest. You can actually turn the oven off, Dad, at this point.
You got it.
Kids burgers are going
looking real nice. We rotated those. We got the adult ones in the oven. They're resting, letting the cheese melt. Buns are growing on, toasting up. Dad's finishing up the sweet potatoes. We're gonna get the rest of these going real quick for you guys. Okay. Quick spread. That's all it is, guys. Just to get the toastiness and get the flavor into the bun. Like I said before, if you guys didn't hear, I want to make sure that you toast up the buns with the burger, because the natural, you know, juices that come out of the burger are gonna, you know, therefore soften the bun up more. So if you have it already nice and toasted, then it's gonna cause it like a little barrier, right? A little barrier that keeps it, you know, nice and crunchy for when you bite in. They all play like a significant part in a good burger. Yeah, thanks for unbanning him. Nightbot's a little strict, guys. Nightbot's a little bit strict, so you wanna make sure you keep away from messing with him. Max can go ahead and unban you guys if you need it. Him and Gmo are my main mod, so they're going to go ahead. And if you have any questions, guys, anything you need to know, anything you want to ask, if you have any recommendations, go ahead and tell InCharge087 or Daddy Gmo. They're my mods. They're out here. Double back. Okay, yeah. I see you, Jason. I see you in chat. Thanks for stopping by, brother. Nice to hear from you, dude.
Crank this up a little more, Dad, to the left side at least.
So we're going to go ahead and crank the heat up, let those get nice and toasty. We got another batch that's about to get thrown on there. I'm actually going to go ahead and throw one more on there. Top and a bottom. Yeah. Dad's got the sweet potato chips coming out real, real nice. I'm going to take the onions. I'm just going to throw them in the oven, let the residual heat that was sitting in there kind of warm them up a little bit. All right, so we got the onion in there. We got our buns ready. We're going to slice the avocado. I can do it pretty soon, actually. I'll show you guys how I kind of fan out my avocado for my burgers. We still got to cut the heirloom tomato. We'll go ahead and get those sliced up. Heirloom tomato is one of my favorite ingredients when it comes to pretty much anything. Salads, burgers, sandwiches, whatever. You find a fresh heirloom when they're in season, the sweetness is incredible, right? Very different than a regular tomato, super acidic. A lot of people don't like tomato. If you don't like tomato, go ahead and try out an heirloom tomato. I'm telling you, they're super, super delicious. Catch up with you guys real quick. I'm keep getting deleted. I don't know. We'll have to make some adjustments to, you know, Nightbot next week and see what's going on with that. I'm really enjoying the father-son duo. I appreciate that very much. It's great cooking with my dad. I'm glad we got to do this. The burger's looking good. Yes, they are.
I'm coming at you. Go for it. Right, go ahead. Kids burgers flip. Beautiful crust on those for them. My girls, my little sisters,
really, really do enjoy food. They got that Italian blood in them. They're like me and my father. They really enjoy food. They love trying all sorts of different things. So when we tell, you know, my little sisters that we're cooking up elk and bison burgers, they're not going to be like, eh, like most kids. They're like ready to go, super excited to see what we got in store for them. You know what I'm saying? We got buns toasted up. Let's get on over there again.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Getting a lot toastier. What I like to see. Alright. So the left side is definitely hotter.
Go ahead and taste the chip. Nice and crunchy. Perfect.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit more
seasoning.
A little bit more cumin.
Okay.
A little bit more salt. Perfect. Alright, so we'll get the rest of these going. We'll grab those tomatoes.
We're going to put them in the fridge.
I took them out and put them on the side for you.
The tomato? Oh, okay, yeah. I got you. Alright. We got our fresh heirlooms, guys, from the store. Get the sticker off. Okay. We got these beautiful, beautiful heirlooms. Delicious. Nice and firm. You don't want to get them too squishy. I'm going to go ahead. Just going to slice them up. Get that end off. The ends of these things, you know, not so good. Kind of bitter. They have a little bit of residual dirt and build up on them from the plant. These things just slice through like butter. Does help that I got a nice sharp knife. Breaking in Dad's new knives. Cuts really nicely. Here, I'll get like a knife close up for you guys on the next one. This thing just falls through like butter. Right. That's the end of the tomato. Put that to the side. Check the girls' burgers real quick. Like I said, we're gonna let the girls' burgers go a little bit longer. I'm gonna throw cheese on there, let them go, and then we're gonna get those in the oven ready to go.
Got enough cheese?
Yeah, it should be alright.
A little piece right here.
That should be plenty. No, I don't mind eating that, that's for sure. We got cheese loaded up on the girls' burgers. We're gonna go back to the board. We got 2, 4, 6, 7. Usually do about, you know, one or two per burger depending on who wants it. I like two on mine. I'm gonna go ahead, cut the end off like I said before. As you can see, you know, it's got like this weird, bitter, you know, grindy taste to it. Is there a delay is banning Smelfy? No, don't ban him. I really got a thank you. Ash and Obs. Gmo, what's good? I love it. I love seeing you guys chop it up in the chat. It's awesome. We're going to go ahead and get the rest of the tomato cut up, guys. Just nice slices. Nice even slices. Not too thick, not too thin. About a 12th of an inch or so. Be perfect. Got our tomato sliced up, guys. We're going to get these on the side. Well, I love heirloom tomatoes. Look at this center. I mean, it's just delicious. You got the multicolors. It's all sweet. Even the seeds in these, I mean, it's so delicious. It's not like a regular tomato. For all you tomato haters out there, give heirloom tomatoes a try. I'm telling you, they're delicious. How are those buns looking, Dan?
They're looking pretty good. Yeah. Switched the newer ones over to the hotter side.
Once they start to get just like a crust like that, they'll be fine.
These are got a good crust on it.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead and let's. That's perfect. I have four more I need to put on, so go ahead and just take four off. Let's
go ahead and throw them there. We'll throw them in the oven in one of those pans just to keep the heat going.
The girls' burgers about ready to go too.
So I'm gonna go ahead.
Excuse me, Ash. Go ahead.
We got our melted burgers, guys. Looking real, real good. Pops, if you don't mind grabbing the girls' burgers, throwing them on here for me real quick. Make a little bit of room. Alright, we got all the burgers. We're going to put them in the oven.
Thank you very much.
Alright, guys. Ash, why don't you come on over and say hi. Guys, this is my little sister. She's been watching the whole time. Go ahead and say hi to everybody. She's going to be eating one of the burgers tonight. She's been super excited. She's over here watching, learning all sorts of things from her older brother. So she's saying hi. Say hi to Uncle Steve and Benito.
Hi.
All right. Thanks for stopping over by. All right, guys. So Dad's over here on bun patrol. He's making sure they get all nice and toasty. We got the last bit of sweet potatoes in the fryer looking good. Yeah. Go ahead and get all the buns toasted up. We're coming. We're just getting down to the end. We got avocado to slice up. We got the chips coming out real good. God, they smell phenomenal, guys. Seriously. Look at these chips. We got beautiful chips, guys. Beautiful, beautiful chips, right? Nice and crunchy. Super delicious. Just unbelievable. Perfect. This is, you know, kind of happy hour bar food, right? Sweet potato chips on the side. Real, real good. Uncle Steve said, finally. Luckiest little girl on the planet. Yeah, she's about to be eating good tonight. She always eats good, though. Dad's a cook, you know what I'm saying? Always eating good. So we're going to go ahead. I'm going to show you guys how I do the avocado. So make your incision into the side, in the skin, right? And just kind of work your knife around in a circle. Match it up to the other side, right? By doing so, right, releases the avocado very nicely. And then my little thing that I like to do, which I was taught, is with a knife, break it into the pit, loosen it up, pop it out. Got our avocado. We're going to go ahead and do that to the second one, guys.
You want these in the oven?
Yeah, go ahead. Right. our avocado, right? Hit it. Perfect, right? Sneak it out the cutting board, right?
I think Suzanne and I both have stories about taking out avocado pits that we didn't
want to. Yeah, definitely. Uncle Steve says hi. My name is Drew. Aubrey, come here. This is my other little sister, guys. You just saw Ashlyn. This is my little sister, Aubrey. Why don't you come say hi? Are you excited to eat your meal?
Yeah.
Yeah, does it smell good?
Uh-huh.
Say hi to Uncle Steve and Benito and everybody.
Hi.
All right, now get out of the way. All right, so what we're going to do, guys, take the avocado, cut it in half, right? That way, you have your avocado. You just kind of peel the back off of it, right? Comes off nice and easily. These potatoes got a little bit of brown on them, a little brown. Not a bad thing, right? If anything, that part of the avocado has got a little bit more flavor in it. So we got our avocado. We're going to go ahead and peel these off. Quarter them all up real quick. Hi, Aubrey. I love when Drew puts his meat between the... Yep. Everyone's saying so cute. I haven't seen your little sister. Rob says, I haven't seen your little sister since they were 2 and 5. Yeah, it's a long time ago, right? Uncle Steve says hi. All right, guys, we got the avocados. We're going to peel the rest of them out, right? See? Let's fold it right off. Sometimes they tend to break. It's fine. Just give it a nice little peel around, right? We searched the store, my dad, for some really – we pretty much got the only two ripe avocados that we could find in the store. It's pretty ridiculous. I don't know what was going on, but – they had no ripe avocados in the store we went to. It was so bizarre. We lucked out by getting just a couple, but this is all we need for the burgers, so it's working out good. How are we looking on the buns, Dad? Looking good?
Yeah, let me get these.
Sweet potatoes about ready?
Sweet potatoes are all ready.
Yep. Perfect. All right, guys, we're getting real close up to plate up. I'm going to go ahead and fan these avocados out. I'm going to show you guys how I put my burgers together, and we're going to get to eating. All right, so I got the avocados all peeled up. I'm going to go ahead and wash my hands. Excuse me.
All right.
So we got the avocados quartered. We got them peeled. Now I get a cameo. Video lagging. Sometimes, you know, you just need to give a nice little refresh. I hope it's not lagging for everybody. Uncle Steve said I watched them YouTube clowns for an hour just to see them. All right, guys, so...
A lot of love out there, Steve.
For the avocado... Oh, I got one more that I didn't peel. Sorry, we can put that on the side. For the avocado, I just make my incisions, right? Right on the side. And then by doing so, you can kind of fan it out into these little fans, right? So you got your little avocado fan right there. Press real nicely on a burger. Yeah, thank you, Ashton. So for, like, these weaker parts, right... They're pretty squishy because of the way that these avocados were that we got were, you know, just barely ripe. So these aren't the freshest avocados. So all we're going to do is just kind of give them a nice little chop. We want them to fan down so they sit, you know, really nicely in the burger. If you have, like, you know, whole clump avocado, it's just going to make the whole burger kind of a little odd, a little harder to eat. So you just want to make it a little easier to eat. I do my avocado on the bottom part of the bun. Always helps. Just little cut marks, fan them out. That one's got brown. I'll take that one. I don't mind. All right, so we got our avocado fanned out. All right, we got our sweet potatoes ready. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get the butter lettuce ready for you guys. Butter lettuce, one of my favorite lettuces to use. Super, super sweet, very fresh. You even buy it, live. So it's even got the root on it. So butter lettuce. Amazing. This is really fresh, really clean. The market that we went to did a really good job of cleaning it up. Sometimes it'll have a lot of dirt since it is live. So if you do notice it is dirty, go ahead and give it a little wash up. This one's nice. So, you know, everyone's just going to get a nice little piece of butter lettuce. I'm just going to grab, you know, nice little leaves, throw on the buns. Nothing crazy. All right. So we got our lettuce. Ready to go. We're going to go ahead and get ready to plate up. Dad's going to pull the burgers out right now. We got the red onion that was sitting in the oven heating up. Ashlyn, why don't you go right ahead and grab me 7 plates, white plates.
I've never had those
Are there? Just grab them a couple at a time.
You need to. Got them? No, get the big pair. We'll get the big ones. Okay. Well, you hold these. Okay. I'm going to grab these. Alright.
We got plates. Oh, I don't need those. You can put them back. Yeah, we don't need those. Okay.
I get big burger plates.
Alright, guys. I'm going to do a couple plates at a time for you guys so you can see. I'm back. Lonzo Ball, the truth. Alright, guys. We're going to go ahead. We're going to get plated up for you guys. I'm going to show you guys how I do it. You're fine. Alright, so. With the buns. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let me go ahead and use those.
Yeah, these are the warmer ones.
Okay.
Those I didn't have.
You can go ahead and throw those in. Okay. So for the buns. Got bun. Top, bottom, right? So we got the Dijonnaise toasted in there. You guys can see the color, right? The color that it kind of adds in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to lightly take a little bit more, give it like just on the bottom of the bun, and just give one more spread. So you already have the toasted part of it. So now you're just going to get like a nice little fresh dabble of it, nothing crazy. All right, so we got our Dijonnaise down, our bun's toasted. I always do avocado on the bottom of my burgers, right below the meat. So I'm going to go ahead and take my fresh avocado, kind of press it down in there, nice and flat. Make sure they're not too lumpy, that way the burger doesn't kind of fall apart and offset. So kind of press the avocado into the bun, right? Lay that down, perfect. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and grab our burger. We got our delicious half elk, half bison burger that we're laying down, okay? So meat is on. So we got bun. We got a little fresh Dijonnaise on there, right? We got avocado. We got burger. We got cheese. So now we're going to go ahead. We're going to take our grilled red onion, right, that Dad did at the beginning. We're going to go ahead and throw these babies on there. Nice and spread out. Okay. So we got our red onion down. Based on the slices of these, size of these heirloom tomato, we're just going to go ahead and throw one heirloom down, okay? Go ahead and get some butter lettuce on there, depending on the size of the leaf. Sometimes I like to rip them in half, make it fit a little bit better. So we got our butter lettuce on both sides, right? We're going to go ahead and apply the bun. And we're not done at the bun, guys, right? Like I said. So we got our burger, right? Now, what I do for my burgers, which, you know, a little bit more fancy, a little bit more upscale for a burger, adds a nice touch. You also can eat them in it. Super, super delicious. We're going to go ahead and add our stick. So it's pretty much like a garnish for the burger, right? So you got your stick, right? So you're going to take, it's all good. You're going to take your pickle. All right, we're going to put it to the top, and we're going to go ahead and put a fresh pepper on top of that, right? What we're going to do is we're going to stab that into the top of the burger, let it sit right on top. Once again, guys, you got your pickle that looks like, you know, just about the size of Garrett, right? So you got your pickle. We're going to go ahead and stab it, okay? We're going to grab another pepper, okay? We're going to go ahead and slide the pepper on there. And we're going to go ahead and stab that into the top of the burger, right? We're going to go ahead and grab our sweet tater chips, right? Whoa. Garrett keeps going, whoa. We're going to get a handful of our tater chips down. Okay. Perfectly cooked by my pops. Got a handful of tater chips down. All right, guys. So what we're looking at here is bread, Dijonnaise, fanned out avocado pressed down, burger, smoked Gouda sitting on top. We got our grilled red onion on top of that, slice of red sweet heirloom tomato, the nice sweet fresh butter lettuce on top of that, fresh brioche bun. We got our pickle and our sweet pepper on top, side of us fresh homemade sweet potato chips. Looking real good. And then with the sweet potatoes, guys, we did add a little bit of fresh coriander that was crushed, salt, and cumin. Toss the chips up. Really nice combination for sweet potatoes. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and give you guys the downward angle at this burger once again. We got our sweet potato chips. We got our burger. I'm going to go ahead and tip it so you guys can see. Right, we got our garnish on top. All right, we're looking real good. This is tonight's episode. We did a half elk 50-50 bison burger, mile high burger. It's what I'm calling it for my fifth episode. I'm going to go ahead and plate the rest of these up off. Matt, thank you very much for the 100 bits. I appreciate that very much. Thank you very much. Maxie, throwing 446 bits at me. Thank you very much, guys, for the tip. I seriously could not appreciate it enough. Hope you guys enjoyed tonight's episode. I've been up here. I'm going to be up here till Sunday visiting with my family. I was really hoping that we were going to do this. My dad approached me saying he wanted to do this. I couldn't have a better sous chef with me tonight. Got my little sister here. She's ready to munch on the burger.
She can't wait. It's 9 o'clock, almost 9 o'clock.
Show the plate here. She's again. Show the plate again. All right, so we got, here's your burger, G. Right? Ash, you want to hold that one up?
Yeah.
Perfect. Here, go up a little bit. Go higher.
It's right here.
Right there. So we got our burgers, guys, right? Mile High Burger by your boy Cousin Drew, fifth episode. Thanks again for stopping by, guys. I cannot appreciate the support enough. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much. We had some new faces in here tonight.